Is there something specific you look at when you're making investment decisions? Like what makes up one investment better than another in your experience?
I think, like, you know, particularly maybe that's a great question, Kima. But before I answer that, let me just give you a little bit of context about what we do at Madrona, so that might help you think about, because investment, like, you know, you can be like, you know, early stage investor, or mid stage investor, later stage investor, or whatever else it is, kind of thing, right? So Madrona has been around for, like, you know, about 26 years in Seattle, okay, and we are predominantly what I call an early stage venture capital firm, focused on investing in information technology. So companies at the seed stage or Series A stage is our sweet spot, okay? And historically, this is what we've been doing for the last 26 years, and it has worked out really, really well for us. But then about 3-4 years ago, or maybe even 5 years ago, we started thinking about, like, you know, hey, we now have experience investing from day one for the long run with all these companies. We've seen a number of these companies scale to a considerable size and scope and scale, and get to the IPO milestone and be publicly traded companies. So we have that experience. We also have experience in certain technology areas, whether it is cloud infrastructure, being, like, you know, Seattle being the cloud capital, or whether it is ML and AI, given what is happening in town, kind of thing. So we felt that we had some, you know, deep expertise in a few technology areas. We had seen enough companies that go through from a very early stage to a very late stage, kind of thing. So we thought, like, you know, hey, we have enough experience and capability to be able to invest in companies at the mid stage, or what we call acceleration stage, companies that are raising Series B or Series C, or even occasionally Series D, kind of thing. So we raised a second fund. Okay. So we today have two funds that we deploy out of, one that is seed and Series A focused, and one that is Series B and Series C focused. So we have a platform that enables us to invest from the day one to a mid stage of the company, kind of thing. Okay. And so that's what we do. Okay. And when we think about early stage, very early stage investments, right? Oftentimes we meet entrepreneurs who are like, hey, I think I have an idea. I may have a slide deck, or I may not have a slide deck or a pitch deck, but that's all I have. Right. Mm. And I might have a co-founder. So you are starting to have to make decisions about investing in a company at that stage. Okay. Now, when the company has made some progress, it's reached a Series B or Series C, then it is different, because then you think about, like, hey, do you have product market fit? Okay. What are your customers saying? Okay. What is your land and expand strategy? What is your net retention rate looking like? Though it's early days, right? But you have a set of metrics and enough signal or data from the market and from customers to be able to give us some, you know, kind of, you know, view into, hey, do we believe that this is a big play or not, kind of thing. But when you're talking about early stage, you don't have any of that, right? So to answer your question specifically, Kima, particularly for early stage companies, for me, it starts with the caliber of the team, okay? And the caliber of the team may be just caliber of the founder, or maybe a couple of co-founders, kind of thing, right? Because at the end of the day, it's the people that are going to either make or break, okay? So to me, like, you know, I need to, and it's almost like, you know, it's a combination of what have you accomplished, and what do I see in terms of, you know, your values, your attributes, how you think about things, your passion for what you're trying to do, and whether you have what it takes to persevere and to be able to, like, you know, navigate the twists and turns and be able to create some huge enterprise value, right? So for me, it starts with the team. Once sort of you get conviction on the team, then you think about, broadly speaking, at least, what is the problem space that they're going after, and whether that problem space is a real problem that we think, like, you know, hey, people are going to want to see a solution right away, or is this one of those nice to have things that people may get there or may not get there, kind of thing. Hey, we sometimes refer to it as, like, you know, hey, are you building a painkiller, or are you building a vitamin? Okay. Knowing that, like, you know, you're building a painkiller makes it even more exciting. Okay. And the third thing is really, like, you know, hey, how big is your vision? How big is your dream, or how big is the opportunity size? Okay. Is it, like, going to be what I call, like, you know, a multi-billion dollar business? Is it going to be, like, you know, a $50 million business? What is it going to be, kind of thing? And being able to get a view on, like, you know, hey, what the opportunity size could look like. So those are the three things I look for in saying, like, you know, hey, is this something that makes sense for us? Should we be leaning in, and should we be investing? The fourth thing, which is important both for us and for the entrepreneur, is, hey, are we the right partners for you? We have a certain set of skill set. We have a certain set of experience. We do things in a particular way. We can be helpful in certain things. Is that what you're looking for? Is that what is going to be most helpful to you, most useful to you as you build the company, as you scale the company kind of thing? And if the answer is yes, then we are absolutely, you know, want to do that.